Hello dear students, so now today we would move ahead in the second chapter of class 6 mathematics, that is playing with numbers. So here we are to find out the HCF also. So I have some new questions for you. Question is, what is the HCF of two consecutive, first one, two consecutive numbers? If you have two consecutive numbers means one after another. Let's say first one number is 1, then second number is 2. Similarly, if you are taking one number 2, then another number is, other consecutive number after 2 is 3. Okay, so these are, if you are taking any two consecutive numbers at random, so what would be the HCF of those two consecutive numbers? So let's take any two consecutive number. Let's take 4 and 5. Yes, so let's take 4 and 5. Okay, so just find out the HCF of 4 and 5. What are the factors of 4? Factors of 4 are 2, 2 ja 4, isn't it? And factors of 2, 2 ja 4 and 1 also, 2, 2 ja 4, 4 1 ja 4. And similarly, factors of 5 are 5 1 ja 5 prime factors, isn't it? We have taken two consecutive numbers 4 and 5 here. And you think getting it or not? We have taken two consecutive numbers 4 and 5 and we are finding out the HCF. Okay, so first we are finding out the prime factorization of 4, and it is 2 multiply 2 multiply 1, 2 2 ja 4, 1 ja 4. Similarly, prime factorization of 5, if you see, it is how much? 5 1 ja 5. Now, if you see the common factor there, what is the common factor then? HCF is what? Common factor. So common is what? Common is only 1 there. So if you are taking any consecutive numbers, any two consecutive numbers, so you would be finding the HCF 1 always. Let's take 5 and 6. Both are consecutive numbers. Factors of 5, 5 1 ja 5. Factors of 6, 2 3 ja 6, 6 1 ja 6. What is the common factor again? Again the common factor is 1. So always you would find 1. Okay. So if you are taking two consecutive numbers, so their HCF would always be 1. So answer is what here? Answer is 1. HCF of two consecutive numbers is 1. Isn't it? Okay. Now moving towards the next question is, HCF of two consecutive even numbers. Now if you are taking two even numbers, consecutive even number, first even number is 2, and the after 2, what is the second even number? 4. Isn't it? So these are the two consecutive even numbers. Means the even number, those who are coming one after another. Okay. So if you are taking first consecutive, first even number as 2, and the second consecutive even number after 2 is 4. Okay. So let's find out their HCF. First, find out the factors of prime factorization of 2. If you are just doing prime factorization of 2, you are getting 2 1 ja 2. And similarly, prime factorization of 4 is 2 2 ja 4 and 4 1 ja 4. Okay. Now, if you see the common factor, what is the common factor there? 2 is the common factor and 1 is also common factor. So answer is 2 1 ja. One common factor is 2. Other common factor is 1. So HCF would be what? HCF is 2 1 ja 2. Okay. So it means if you are taking two consecutive even numbers, so HCF would be 2 in each case. Okay. Let's take one more example. Now some other consecutive numbers. Let's take 6 is an even number, and after 6, what is the consecutive even number after 6? 8. Isn't it? Yes. So these are the two consecutive even numbers. So prime factorization of 6, just find out the prime factorization of 6. You are knowing how to find out. So you would be getting 2, 3 ja 6, 1 ja 6. Isn't it? Similarly, prime factorization of 8, do it. 2, 4 ja 8, 2, 2 ja 4 and 2, 1 ja 2. So 2, 2, 2 and 1 means you are getting 2 multiply 2 multiply 2 and 1. So again, if you see the common HCF, highest common factor. So what are the common factors there? 2 is common, 1 is common. Only these two are there. So answer would be 2 multiply 1. So answer would be 2 again. Isn't it? Okay. So anytime if you are taking two consecutive even numbers, so every time you are going to find out the HCF as 2. Okay. So HCF of two consecutive even number would be how much? How much? 2. Answer is what here? 2. You can write down the examples also that I have told to you. Okay. Okay. Now the next one is two consecutive odd numbers. If you are taking now two consecutive odd numbers, so what would be the HCF of two consecutive odd numbers? Let's say, what is the first odd number? 1. And after 1, what is the next odd number? 3. 1 and 3. Isn't it? Let's take two odd numbers, 1 and 3. Just prime factorization do now. Prime factorization of 1 is only 1. Prime factorization of 3 is 3, 1 ja 3. So what is the common factor? Only 1 is the common factor. So HCF is what? 1. Let's take one more example. Let's take some other consecutive odd number. Let's say 1 is 7. After 7, what is the other odd number? 9. Isn't it? 9. Now prime factorization do. If you are doing the prime factorization of 7, it would be how much? 7, 1 ja 7. If you are doing the prime factorization of 9 is, it is 3, 3 ja 9, 1 ja 9. Again, if you see what is the common factor there, again it is 1. Isn't it? Isn't it? So again, the HCF is how much? HCF is 1. So every time if you are taking two consecutive odd numbers, so every time you are going to find out the HCF as 1. Isn't it? Yes. So HCF of two consecutive odd numbers is how much? Answer would be 1. You can give the example that I have given to you. Okay? Getting it or not? Now moving towards the next question. Question is, HCF of co-prime numbers 4 and 15 was found as follow. You have taken two co-prime numbers, 4 and 15. 4 and 15 are co-prime numbers. How? Because if you see the factors of 4 and 15, you would have only one as the common factor between these two. The numbers which have only one as the common factor, you would be calling such number as co-prime number. That already I have told to you. Okay. So now, HCF of co-prime number was found as follows. So this is how the HCF was found. Okay. First, we have to find out the prime factorization of 4. So it is 2 ja 4. Then prime factorization of 15, it is 3 multiply 5. Okay. Now, since is there any common factor? No. So since there is no common factor, so the HCF of 4 and 15 is 0. Is it true? Is this answer correct? Should the HCF of 4 and 15 be 0? Just guess it. Because there is no common factor between 4 and 15. If you are doing the prime factorization of 4, it is 2 multiply 2. And prime factorization of 15, it is 3 multiply 5. Now you can see here is no common factor. So if there is no common factor, so HCF should be 0. Is this correct answer? If not, find your correct answer then. Yes, I am saying it is not incorrect. It is not the correct answer. Then how would you find out the correct answer? So let's find out the correct answer. This is not correct. So let's find out the correct answer now. Correct answer. So how do you find out the correct answer? First, you do the prime factorization of 4. Prime factorization of 4, if you are doing like this, 2 2 4, 2 1 2, and 1 is also there. No? So you have to write 2 multiply 2 multiply 1. Similarly, if you are to do prime factorization of 15, so you are going to get 3 5 15 and 1 again. Isn't it? Now, if you see the common factor, HCF, you are going to find out. So what would be the HCF? What is the common factor here? Common factor is 1. So answer would be 1. So HCF is what here? 1. This is the correct answer. Okay, so rather writing the HCF as 0, you would have to write answer as 1. Isn't it? Getting it or not? Okay, just note it down. Then after, we would be moving in the next lecture. Rather, I will be telling to you about how to find out the HCF by one more method we have. Okay, till now we are knowing only one method, that is prime factorization method. Okay, so in the next lecture, we are going to discuss the Euclid division algorithm. How we are going to use this Euclid division algorithm to find out the HCF of two given numbers or three numbers. Okay, getting it or not? So we would be doing that in the upcoming lecture. Till then, stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you. Have a good day.